Dear students, I am Mohini Deshmukh from Techno India Group Public School. Today we are going to start the chapter first of class 6, that is food, where does it come from? Before that, we have to know that what are the different parts of the plants. There are different parts of the plants that are leaves, bud, flower, stem, root. These are the different parts of the fruit. These are the different parts of the plants. So those parts of the plants which are which we see above the soil, we call that shoot system, and the part of the plant which is below the soil, that we call the root system. So in shoot system, what parts of the plant include? Flower, fruit, leaves, stem and fruit. These are the different parts of the plant which comes on the shoot system. Okay, so these and the root which is going inside the soil, that is the main root. This is the main root of the plant, and from that main root there are different branches of the roots comes out, that we call the secondary roots. It comes from the main root. So this undergoes into the soil, that is the root system. And the parts from where the part of the plant from where the leaves come out, that we call the node. That is the node, and the distance between this and this, these are the two nodes from where the leaves are coming out. The distance between these two nodes are called internode. And the bud is shown here. So the distance between the two nodes, that is internode. These are the edible parts of the plants. How we can say that these are the edible parts of the plants? Because pomegranate is the fruit, but which part of the pomegranate we eat? We eat the seeds of the pomegranate. And mango is the fruit. Okay, and spinach and fenugreek, that is the leaves which we use as a vegetable in our diet. And groundnut, these are the seeds which we use in our diet. That are the different parts. Flower, what is the example of flower? Cauliflower, which we use as a vegetable, which is used in the form of flower in our diet. So these are the edible parts of the plants. Then our next topic of our chapter, that is the grouping of the animals. The grouping of the animals is mainly or majorly in the three parts, that is herbivores, carnivores and omnivores. Why we grouping in these three parts of these animals? Because it depends on the eating habits of the animals. So herbivores, the first is herbivores. What we call the herbivores? The animals which eat only the green plants, we call them herbivores. What is the example of herbivores? Goat, cow, buffaloes, these are some examples of the herbivores animals. Then turn over the carnivores. Carnivores are those animals which eat only the flesh of other animals, or they depend completely on the other animals, which called carnivores. What are the examples of carnivores? Lion, tiger, these are the examples of carnivores animals. Then the third part of this animal, that is the omnivores. Omnivores means they depend on both plants as well as animals. We group as omnivores. So these are the three major groups of the animals which depend on the eating habits of the animals. So today we discuss about these parts, that is edible parts of the plants and the grouping of the animals. I hope all students understand this.